If he tries to back you in, don't try to use your hips to stop his progress. As soon as you do that, he'll spin and beat you. Rather, stay in your stance with your bump out. Move in short hops so that you can keep your base. Now, if you're guarding a player who has a pet move that you're having trouble stopping, body up with him by chesting that favorite shoulder as soon as he catches the ball. Whenever your man takes a shot in the post, you must wall and block. Both arms go straight up. This is low percentage in terms of creating a foul. The advantages are you can block his vision, change his shot a little, and most importantly, make a quick turn into a blockout. Your man has used his best move to create space, and he thinks all that's left is a swish. But you can still get a stop. Regardless of a player's pass or shot fakes or how they catch the ball, 99% of jump shooters bring the ball through their chest area when they take their shot. You can block the shot by sticking your hand in this key area. For example, you can strip the quick draw. Or after you stop the drive, you can block or change his shot on the way up. Or if he flies by but decides to pull up, recover and strip him. If you can't block your opponent's shot from his shot pocket, then jump with the shooter, keeping a visible gap between your bodies. Let the official see that there is no contact going up, and the space will allow you to land without brushing him on the way down. Best case scenario, you deflect the ball and ensure he misses. If you don't get the ball, at least you'll change his shot. If you can't change his shot, at least your hand will disrupt or block his view of the goal. The flyby is used when you're recovering to a shooter and your sole job is to change his shot. In other words, a closeout will be far too late to prevent the shot. Choose a side so you don't run into him, then literally fly by and swipe with the hand closest to the shooter. An all-out sprint and a violent swipe might not deflect the shot, but you will distract him or make him rush his shot. Are you willing to do whatever it takes to be the best, to separate yourself from your competition? You can condition your body to be a defensive machine by adding these defensive drills to your workout. There are an infinite number of drills that will improve your speed, quickness, and athletic ability. But the five drills in this section emphasize the footwork and types of movement you'll need to master the techniques in this video and become a great defensive player. They will build your ability to move laterally and change directions quickly. Now, don't spend too long on any one drill. Instead, do each drill for 10 to 20 seconds, maybe two sets, and then move on to another part of your overall workout. Be sure to keep your feet close to the ground. Again, the emphasis is quick lateral movement and efficient change of direction. Nothing takes the place of repetition to develop the self-confidence you need to be a great defender. Repetition builds habits, and good habits make for great instinctive players. Do each of these drills with perfect technique first, and then concentrate on doing things at a high speed. Again, spend only a few minutes each day with these drills. You want to constantly improve your technique, but you also want to keep it fun. Wall and a ball emphasizes the push-step slide. Start out by throwing the ball at an angle that makes you move only a few feet, but then really push yourself by tossing the ball at greater and greater angles so that you have to really move to reach the ball. The next two workouts are designed to make you use all of the standard defensive movements in a basic pattern. You can time yourself for the whole workout and then try to improve your time the next day. And you don't have to use these exact workouts. Make up your own pattern based on the defensive movements you need to improve upon. These workouts are designed to be done anywhere, in your driveway, in your yard, or on a half court or a full court. Regardless of where you are, don't call it a day until you've done your defensive homework. Partner workouts can be done in a teaching progression, starting with the standard closeout, then adjusting to triple threat, then playing the drive, and eventually leading up to live one-on-one. You'll develop the skills of dominating one-on-one defense in a building blocks fashion. Be warned, closeout one-on-one might be the toughest situation to defend. You've got to guard the shot, play the drive, and you've got no help behind you. But don't ignore closeout one-on-one. It's one of the best ways to simulate the one-on-one situations that occur in real games. The zigzag is meant to simulate game conditions in the full court. Along with incorporating the push-step slide, the swing step, the sprint to cut off, the overplay angle, and the proper gap, it might be the best conditioning workout of the whole bunch. Basketball is a complex and ever-changing game. Some things can't be categorized. But here are some hints that might give you the edge you need. When you're on the perimeter, the shooter has plenty of space he can use to get around a standard blockout. Plus, using an aggressive blockout on the perimeter in plain view of the official might get a foul called on you. Therefore, turn 90 degrees and use what I call a checkout. Put an arm bar across his chest and use it as a feeler. Now you can turn your head and watch the ball. When it hits the rim, release and pursue the ball. When your man has the ball, what part of his body do you want to focus on? Focus on his chest. He can fake with his head, shoulders, his feet, and the ball. Don't focus on those. You'll be able to see them in your peripheral vision. His chest is the only thing he can't fake with. Remember the flyby we talked about in the last chapter? Well, you can really distract the shooter if he thinks you're about to barrel into him. Just make sure you don't make contact with him. That would be a foul. Have you ever seen coaches make their players work on step sliding or other defensive movements without using their hands? Well, defense is certainly about feet and positioning, so I understand that drill. But to really help your speed, especially in the fourth quarter, try exaggerating movement with your arms and hands. Consider a 100-meter sprinter. Do they run with their hands tied behind their backs? No, they use them to pump their legs through the sprint. You can use your hands to help you move through any defensive movement. When you're back on defense and a speed dribbler is heading toward you at a stampede speed, you don't want to attack him head on. If you do, he'll use a simple in and out and blow by you. Instead, begin to retreat and match his speed so that you can angle him to the outer third away from the goal. You've always been told to use ball fakes, foot fakes, or shot fakes when you're on offense. But have you ever thought of faking on defense? For example, if you're getting back on defense with a dribbler speeding towards you, fake at the dribbler while you're retreating. This won't put you in the